Good morning, students. Today we would be talking about appeal and revision. Now, when we talk about appeal, appeal is a creation of statute, and right to appeal is neither a natural right nor an inherent right. It is a continuation of a suit proceeding. So now, appeal may be from original decree or from appellant decree. And also where a person is aggrieved from a decree passed by the court of original jurisdiction in a suit tried by it, it is called as the first appeal. When a person aggrieved by appellate court decree passed by the appellate court prefers an appeal against that decree, it is the second appeal or the special appeal. So now what is memorandum of appeal? Memorandum of appeal, when we talk about that, when a party aggrieved by a decree or an order of the court appeals by presenting a memorandum of appeal to the appellate court that sets forth the ground of objection of the decree or the order appealed against. So the grounds are set forth without any arguments and are numbered, and the advocate must ensure that every ground of objection is set forth in the memorandum, because if any ground is not present or omitted, the appellate cannot urge or be heard in support of it except by leave of the court, which is not granted as a matter of course. It is because the respondent must have fair notice of the ground of objection which he has to meet at the hearing of the appeal. But the appellate court is not precluded from deciding appeal on other grounds. So when we talk about memorandum of appeal, it is setting for the ground upon which judicial examination is prayed for. It should contain concisely and under separate heads the ground of objection, and the memorandum is often need to be accompanied by a copy of decree appealed from. Now a memorandum of appeal is different from petition, so therefore no enumeration of facts of the case, no complaint against high handedness of the other party, no plea of the helpless condition of the appellant, and no plea for sympathy of the court should find any place in the memorandum. So all these things would not be there in the memorandum. The memorandum has, when you write a memorandum, it has to have two parts, the formal part and the material part. Now the formal part would have the following things. For example, in the formal part, you would write the heading of the case, that is the court name and address of the parties, and name of the appellant being given first, then the respondent name is given. Now second would be an introductory state of the appellant, that is the state. This statement must give the particulars of decree or order appealed from. What happens in a petition, you would enumerate the facts. Here you're not enumerating the facts. Then you would be writing about the valuation of appeal. This is what would be there in the formal part of a memorandum of appeal. Now when you write the material part, it would contain the following things, that is it would contain the ground of appeal. Now ground of appeal or objection should be written distinctly and specifically. It should be written concisely, and they must not be framed in narrative or argumentative form. So this is how you draft a memorandum of appeal. Now students, when we we would be talking about revision. So revision under section 115 of the Code of Civil Procedure acts as the source for the High Court to supervise the subordinate court, and the same was held in Shiv Shakti Cooperative House versus Messrs Swaraj Developers, which is a 2003 Supreme Court judgment. Now the term revision implies examination with intent to improve or correct. Thus, the High Court may correct any illegality, irregularity and impropriety. So the revisional power of the High Court may be invoked upon application or suo motu. If we talk about section 115 of Code of Civil Procedure, it lays down the principle of revision. It says that the High Court may call for the record of any case which has been decided by any court subordinate to such High Court and in which no appeal lies thereto. And if such subordinate court appears, number one, to have exercised a jurisdiction not vested in it by law, number two, have failed to exercise a jurisdiction so vested, or number three, to have acted in the exercise of jurisdiction illegally or with material irregularity. So the three situation that is there in section 115 is that if the court have exercised the jurisdiction which it does not have, then the High Court may call for revision, or if the court has failed to exercise the jurisdiction which was vested, or number three, if they have the jurisdiction but they have exercised it with irregularity or illegality. So, a high court to entertain a revision in any case decided by subordinate court in certain circumstances, this jurisdiction is known as revisional jurisdiction of the high court. So, now revision meaning the action of revising, especially critically or carefully examination or perusal with a view to correcting or improving. Now, when we talk about revision, so now when the when the lower court does any of the three things, that is they fail to exercise the jurisdiction vested to them, or they exercise the jurisdiction not vested to them, or they have the jurisdiction but they have exercised it with illegality and regularity, on doing so the high court may make such order in the case as it thinks fit, but it shall not vary or reverse any order made or any order deciding an issue in the course of the suit or other proceedings. So, if you talk about this case, that is Major S.S. Khanna versus Bridge F.J. Dillon, the court stated that this particular section, is divided into two parts. Now, the first prescribes the condition in which jurisdiction of the High Court arises, and the second sets out the circumstances in which no appeal lies to the High Court. Now, students, we would be talking about the format. Now, when we see the format, this is the format of appeal. Now, when we see the format of appeal, the first thing is it is addressed to the court. Okay. Now, here you also have to mention, which is not there, that is the name of the parties. Okay, name of the party should be there, that is appellate versus respondent. Then the following grounds would be there. Then your prayer would be there. Then this is the details of the advocate. And here you would write the date and time and place. This is how you will write your appeal. Now, when we do the format of revision, this is the format of revision. Now, the same thing it would happen here, the name of the court, the civil revision number, then the details of the parties, then the subject matter, then what are you asking for, what are the issues involved, the grounds. Then what are you asking for in this revision, and then the details of the parties who is filing the revision. So this is how you have to draft the revision. This format was already shared with you during class also. So student, this was all about appeal and revision. It's a very small topic, but it holds very important place in the functioning of the court. So please pay attention to it. If you have any query with respect to this, please feel free to contact me either through mail or WhatsApp group. Thank you.